and maintain the current preferences we offer.
4 years after its first edition, the UKCI Trade and Investment Forum took place in London on Friday. The outlook for Côte d'Ivoire is largely positive, with the improved business climate as well as investments in infrastructure and service delivery. Already known as the world's largest cocoa producer, the country is full of natural resources, especially in the extractive industries. Though there are political rifts, Côte d'Ivoire is taking actions to ensure sustainable stability and growth. In that regard, the Ivorian Prime Minister, Amadou Gon Coulibaly, led a government delegation to London in order to present not only the many investment opportunities that Côte d'Ivoire has to offer to international investors, but also the plan to transform and develop the country by 2020.
There is an effort that must be made for Britain to become effectively the second trading partner of Côte d'Ivoire, and that is the reason why we are here with you today. A new plan for the period 2016-2020 was established, and this plan is estimated at 30,000 billion CFAs, which is 42 billion pounds sterling.
Donc environ 42 millions de livres.
British existing and potential investors were also able to engage with Ivorian ministers and senior government officials.
The objective of this plan is to make Côte d'Ivoire an emerging country by 2020. In order to do so, we do have a number of projects that we need to implement, and we are here to promote this project because we are looking for technical and financial partners to develop these projects.
We were looking at most of the English-speaking markets and decided, no, we ought to look at the French-speaking markets. So we started with the Côte d'Ivoire. We started, I'll repeat myself, but going to the embassy in the UK first, who were the most helpful embassy, African embassy, in London. When I went to the embassy in the UK, it was all exactly as they promised. The ambassador was there. It was a one-on-one with his secretary. And it was good. The problem with every country in the world, including ours, is funding. So it's finding the right funders, which we're doing, that will fund the projects realistically. I mean, a lot of people talk about PPP, private finance. Some of those are good, some of those aren't so good. The UK has actually found some don't work. So they've got to be really careful. And because countries like us have done it, what will happen now to somewhere like the Côte d'Ivoire is we'll know from the lessons learned what not to do.
I had done a lot of reading on Côte d'Ivoire before I came and have been wanting to actually work with them for a while. So really the conference was a confirmation of what I had already read, and it was also nice to see that the government is really on board and wanting to build stronger connections with the UK market.
Côte d'Ivoire, with its growing economy, now ranks as one of West Africa's best place for doing business. But with a giant like Nigeria competing in the same region, the need for more investment and a sustainable growth is now crucial.
Nigeria is not a rival to us. Nigeria is a brother country, right? And we have each of us our advantages and in different areas, right? Côte d'Ivoire, for instance, is a French-speaking country, and we have a common currency with a lot of countries in West Africa. So Côte d'Ivoire is also a really important port, the port of Abidjan. It's a really dynamic port. And as we used to say, Côte d'Ivoire is the entry port, especially in the French-speaking West African countries. So we have really good infrastructures. We have, as far as roads, energy, we have a knowledgeable workforce. And these are all the elements that make us think that, yes, it is really good for investors to come and invest in Côte d'Ivoire.
The second sector we can believe is trade. If you can import and sell,